Hi, welcome to NetSet OS. Today I'll be starting a new playlist on regular expressions. I have already made playlist on Python interview questions, Python design pattern, even on data structures and algorithm. You can also find recursion with Python. There are 20 videos in it, so you can refer them. I have also made data structures and algo. Here I have explained the question from very scratch, and also in every question and at last part of the video I have explained data structures and algo with Python code also. So you can refer this. And for Zango project, I have created 3 playlists where you can find a complete project. You can start with Python Zango complete series where there is no prerequisite required. Then you can make your online resume using Python Zango, which is deployed on Heroku. And also you can deploy your website using Zango Forms on Google Cloud. So you can refer them. Now, let's start with regular expressions. So let's know what is regular expressions. A regular expression is a set of symbols representing text pattern. Regular expressions are a tool for matching, searching, and replacing text by describing the patterns that should be used to identify those parts. Regular expressions refer to the larger formal language of the assembles that describes text pattern. So they are not programming language. They are just used for matching, searching, and replacing text. They are just used by programming languages as they are formal language that have defined set of rules that a computer understands. But there are no variables. They don't set values. They don't even contain instructions. And they can't make decisions even. But most programming language makes lots of use of regular expressions. So they are very important and useful tool for working with text. So I suggest every programmer should learn how to use them. Often regular expressions are called regex. Sometimes you will see it written with a P at the end. That's not so common, but you will hear me say regex, because it's shorter and easier to say than our long regular expressions. Let's take a look at some of the ways that you might use regexes to work with text. So these are the applications. First is testing email addresses format. You might test if a credit card number has a correct number of digit, or you might use them to test if an email address is in valid format. You can search a document for the word, let's say, sender. If you look for it, it is spelled both ways, C-E-N-T-E-R or C-E-N-T-R-E. You could also search your document for all occurrences, I, he, or mono. For person, you can replace it with more formal, like Mr. Monish or Mr. David, whatever the name of a person is. Or you could count how many times the word training is preceded by dance, YouTube, computer, etc. In each case, we would use regular expressions to write a description of a desired pattern using symbols. There are even more applications. You can extract data from a PDF invoice, or rather you can extract data from any PDF. For example, I want an email ID, but it's in PDF, and I want all email IDs in a series of PDF. So how I can extract data from there? That we can do with the help of regex. The other one, for a phone number. The pattern might be digits, dash, hyphen, spaces, open or close braces. you can do it with the help of regex. Here we have an example 1, then a braces, then 3 digits, braces, and finally 3 digits with dash and then 3 digits. So we can use symbols to describe this pattern. Once we have defined our pattern, then the regex processor will use our description to look for matching results. The word matches is a keyword and we are going to be using a lot. A regular expression can be said to match text if it correctly describes the text. You can also flip that around and say that text matches a regular expression if it is correctly described by the expression. So you can use it in both ways. Now we will be talking about choosing a regular expression engine. Each implementation or version of regular expression processor can be referred to as engine. Let's take a look at the most popular ones. There is C, C++, Java, JavaScript, .NET and the .NET family, Perl, PHP, Python, Ruby, Unix, Apache, which are really all the different tools that are available for use with Unix. Now there are more engines than this, like grep, egrep. These are just some of the most popular ones. However, there are few differences between them and what engines support. An engine might support all the core features, but also add a few new ones that won't work elsewhere. So in every case, you want to consult the documentation for that language or engine to get its detail. I'm going to be giving you the general principle of regular expression that you can use. You can use the language with which you are comfortable with. Now for this course, we need to install a regular expression engine of your own so that we can try them out. You can choose many programs on your desktop, computer, or even on your phones. You can use grep, egrep from the command line, TextMate, Atom, or Sublime, and Notepad++. Those are text editors. There is regex buddy or regex magic. These are the applications you can download. And then there is a mobile application you can download for your phone as well. In this course, I'm going to be using a free online regular expression tools. There's no installation required. It's going to be cross-platform. That's going to be good for everyone taking this course. I'm going to suggest 3 sites, all very similar. I'm going to be using the first one, regexr.com, but you can use as per your comfort level. I will give the introduction for all these 3 sites, which you can implement for regular expression. Let's take a quick look at all 3. So first one, I'm going to show you regex101.com. So this is regex101.com. So here you can see there is a regular expression written over here. You can type in your regular expression, that's the pattern of symbols. And down here, there is a test string where you could type your test string. The thing that we want to match the regular expression against. And here you can see there are different flavors for regular expression that you can pick here. So if you want PHP implementation, you can go for this. If you want to go for JavaScript, Python, Golang. Here, I'll be using Python. So as I said, those are just slightly different versions of the regular expression engine. And the features just may deviate in a very minute ways. Then there comes regexpal. Here also we have a regular expression. We can type over here. Then we can go for test strings as like which we discussed there. Here we have cheat sheet. As I click here, I can get all the patterns and even what they actually refers. So it's very good for newbie. Then there comes regex EXR, the one I'll be using throughout the tutorial. Here also we have the expression where you can type your regular expression up here in the top, and then down here is the text that we want to match it against. One nice thing about this tool that I like, it actually goes through and explains what each of the symbols in your regular expression mean. So you have some idea of what you are putting up in here. So it will help you to be able to actually debug it as well. It does have different settings, cheat sheet. So we can refer any of these tools as per our comfort level. But I'll be using regexr.com throughout this tutorial. So in this series, I'll be covering up the theoretical concept implementing on practical basis. Here in this series, I'll be using many real world examples. Today in this video, we will know about notation, conventions and modes for regex. This is our second video for regex series. So before we dive into learning about regular expressions, let's just spend some time to know what are flags, modes, and let us know about notations that we are going to use here. Here I'll be using regexr.com for analyzing my text. So before that, we should know whatever the text we used to write. Let's say I want to write learn will be entered within two forward slashes. So these are the two limiters that we should know while talking about regular expressions. So the text, whatever I'm typing here, will be within this forward slashes. So these forward slashes are not part of our expression. They are just the delimiters which are holding it. So you are going to be using it without forward slashes most of the time. Though some programming languages keep it mandatory to use this forward slashes in order to delimit it, so that programming languages can know that it's a regular expression. But in most of the cases, we don't use it. You will be just simply typing them as in a string. So the reason why we use those forward slashes, so as to contrast it against the text string that we are using to match it against. So this regular expression I have used over here, learn, will be going to match. And here I have written a sentence, learning is a key to success. So this regular expression learn is going to match this literal character in a text string. So here it is the expression that if I just select learn, then it is showing learn highlighted in my text body. And if I hold this learn and delete it, you can see that it still has this forward slashes around it and we can't get rid of it. They are just built into it. The first forward slash indicates the start of regular expression, whereas this last forward slash indicates end of regular expression. And if I want to delete this, I can't. As if I want to type over here, let's say key, it just puts it right in between them to let me know that it is a regular expression. And this is a text string, though we don't need to put any kind of quotes over here. Programming languages we use to denote string by quotes, but here we don't need any quotes over here. It simply denotes that it is a text string. And here we have flags where you can see the first is global, with which we will get slash G. If I uncheck it and click on case insensitive, we will get I over here. If I uncheck it and click on multi-line, I will get M over here. We will get to know its usage in some time, but for the time being, these are the flags and they indicate different modes that we are using with our regular expression. For now, I'll turn off all the expression flags. Well, what do those different modes mean? Let us know one by one. The standard mode is just when we have those forward slashes with our regular expression inside. This is our standard mode. Coming to global, global has G after it, and global says match this over and over again throughout our document. Don't just find the first match, rather find all the matches. So if we have 100 page document, it is going to look through all 100 pages. And if we take it away, then it's going to look for the first match. And if you know the difference between find versus find all refers to global. For example, instead of regular expression, I have given learning. And we have 100 documents. So this regular expression learning, it will be going to find out in all 100 documents and will return me where this learning has been used throughout our 100 documents. And if I don't use global, it will be returning just first learning of our first document. That's what find and find all does for us. And then comes case sensitive. This I signifies to insensitive. Insensitive means whatever the regular expressions we are using here, it never pays attention whether we are using in uppercase or lowercase. It just gives the result wherever this regular expression has been used. Though there are other ways also that we will discuss later on, but this is a very useful which we use in our regular expression. Then comes multi-line. This M stands for multi-line, which matches the text that stretches across more than one line. By default, it can span more than one line. And then comes grep. Grep is a program that is very common used on Unix-based system. And grep gets its name by G/RE/P. As we have seen the global flag at the end, here this grep stands for global regular expression to print out the results. So globally search for a regular expressions will print out the results. This is what this program is doing. And grep is very common program in Unix based systems. Here in this video series, I'll be using this term a lot. Here it will oftenly be used as a verb, as if someone says, let me grab that document for you. Here they literally mean, I'm going to take a regular expression and search that document. So basically they are used for analyzing the document. And now you know where the word grep comes from. It comes from the notation convention and the mode that we will use with regular expression. Literal characters. This is our third video in our regex series. So by the word literal characters, we understand that here we have to deal with characters coming from A to Z. It can be spaces, it can be numeric character, anything. Let's say I got a phone and there are numerous chats in a phone. And I got one chat where I just want to find out what kind of relationship these two people maintain. Two people who are chatting on this chat. It can be romantic, it can be secret chat, whatever. But just I want to find out that what kind of relationship this chat has. So what I'll do, I'll take a love sign or rather love word to find out this word is used how many times in this chat. As this chat is very long, maybe up to 5 years. And I want to find out how many times this love word has been used in this chat. So here I'll take the help of regex. And here in this video, we will begin learning the syntax of regular expression by starting just the simplest match of all. Let's say if we have the regular expression that contain love and we have a string just love. So here it will completely match as both are containing the same letters. So it will match a string containing the same characters, which is love. Now, the other situation when we have a regular expression as love, but we have in string love, sick or beloved. Here, this love word will match the first 4 letters of the string, as this regular expression will not match the entire string. It will just going to find out this first 4 letters of this lovesick word. And in case of beloved, here it will check these 4 letters among these complete string. So it is searching throughout the string looking for a match. It's very similar to search inside a word processor. Matching the literal characters from a regular expression to a string is the simplest kind of match there. The only thing that we need to keep in mind is case sensitive, because by default it is always sensitive. So if I have the word love in capital letters and my regular expression is just love, which is in lower case, so here it will not match at all. And I will prefer you to write all your regexes as case sensitive. As when we learn about character classes, we will learn techniques to write regexes that match both uppercase as well as lowercase. Let's try it out practically. So for this, I'm on regexr.com. So here to begin with, let's write love in our regular expression. Now in the text, let's write simple love. As soon as I've written the same word, it says that it matches love and also it gives the range from 0 to 3 index. And here also we can see that a complete word is matching as it is turned to blue. Also, it tells down below that L character matches L character and it is a case sensitive, as I have written both in uppercase. Now let's delete this and I'll write love in lowercase, and in string I prefer to write lovesick or beloved. Here we have a complete word, but if you see it carefully, it doesn't matches the whole thing. It just matches the first 4 letters. We also have love over here, but it will match just the first 4 letters of the first word. Why is it so? Because I haven't used any of the flags over here. If I use global, it will be showing me wherever love word has been used throughout our string will be matched with this love as it is in blue color. And also it will give the indexes. Now I'll go to my regular expression and will make this small L to capital L. You can see it's no longer a match because here comes a case sensitiveness. If we want to match these, we need to change this L into small, or we have another option. We can go to flags and deleting this global, click on case insensitive. And here you can see it matches the first four letters of love. Here it won't be matching this because I haven't clicked on global. So this is a flag telling it that it should be a special behavior for this regular expression. Normally it is a case sensitive, but now it is using case insensitive. As you can see, that is reflected down. This literal character is a case insensitive. But I'll recommend you to not to use case sensitive, as it is not a good practice. If we are working on database, some of the database commands don't allow it. Now I want to show you one more thing. If I add spaces over here in regular expression, and this is a small L. So here you can see it will not match because spaces are also a character. So obviously it will not be matching with our string until unless if you don't add spaces between this love. So here it will be matching this love as it is a same bunch of characters which we have used in regular expression. So as you can see, when I have written this word love in my regular expression, it just signifies the first love, not the other one, because it comes under standard matching and this is by default. So the regex here is doing its work. It's going to read the string from left to right. And when it comes to the first match, throughout the string, it will stop. And here itself, it will return. It won't be going further. Now let's just change our sentence which have the word love. So I'll take the string as lover boy is loved by all lovely ladies, just for instance. So here you can see we have this love word three times. Regex by default uses standard matching. Now I want all the love words in my string. So I'll go to flags and will click on global. So here you can see it's going to find out all the matches throughout the text. So love in global mode would match all three sets of love in this sentence with their respective indexes. Now let's have a simple demonstration. It's simple though, but it will be very helpful when we start looking at more complex examples. So I'm taking with a short string, just by a single sentence. In string, he's left of losses loved by loved ones. Here the regular expression engine starts from the beginning of the string. Does this character H matches with my regular pattern? H is nowhere matching with love. Then it will go to next character. It doesn't match, so it will go to the next, then again next, until it finds the letter L. This first symbol L matches with our first letter of regular expression. So this could be the beginning of our successful match. So it will go to the second letter now. The first letter was matching. Now the second letter we have here in our string A, but in regular expression it's O. O and A are different, so it doesn't match. It will start looking for the last character, as it will backtrack by one. And again, it will start looking for the letter L. So now it will move to the next character, then the next character, then now it reaches L. L here we have for losses, rather our regular expression is love. Now the first two character matches, but when it goes to the third character, it doesn't match. Now it knows that L here is not the beginning of successful match. It doesn't just start from S, it has another possibility it needs to consider. It will go back to O and see if O could be the beginning of successful match. Now in this case, it's obviously not. So when we start writing more complex regular expression, it doesn't know that. So it goes to back and try the next character. And then it is seeing that it is not a match. So it will be going further. And when it reaches at L, it says it's a successful match. If it is in standard mode, it will just be giving the first love. But if we are in global mode, then it will keep going until it finds the second love. So here we have two main things. First is backtracking that it does over here. When it approaches L, then it will go to O. But S is not same as V. So it will backtrack, as regular expression are always eager to return a match for you. And it always moves from left to right and return. And again, it will go for the journey to matches your regular expression in the string. But if you are in standard mode, it will just return the first match they can find. And if it is in global mode, it will find all the letters which are matching with regular expression. In this video, we will learn about meta characters. This is fourth video of regex series. In the last video, we studied about literal characters, where we knew the literal characters are from A to Z, numerical character from 0 to 9, and the spaces. So in this video, we will study about meta characters, which are not literal characters. They are the characters with special meanings. Meta character are those to transform literal characters into powerful expressions. They are very few to learn. Sometimes these characters can have more than one meaning, and we need to understand their context in order to know how they operate inside our particular regular expression. And I'll be spending more of the time in knowing all of these meta characters. Before we dive into learning each of the meta characters, let's go to regexa.com, where we will be using regexa tool. Let's type all the meta characters in our regular expression column. So first space dot asterisk and then space dot, also plus sign, then another space. Here I can use brackets with ABC. Bracket close, then we can give space, dollar, space, question mark, space, bracket, ABC, bracket close, space, backslash, D, then curly braces. Let's write some numerical, 2, 3, curly bracket close. So here we can see different colors representing each of the brackets. For parenthesis, it's green. For square bracket, it's yellow. For curly braces, it's blue. We will get to know each of the meta character one by one. So let's start with first meta character, which is dot. Dot is also said to be period character or wildcard meta character. So instead of dot, we can use any of the character except new line. That means the new line character is not allowed in dot. Dot is just used for one character. Let's try it practically. Here, if I write pat, pot, pat, P-I-T. So I have to write such bunch of characters so as to match these strings at once. So here, if I write P-E-T, so P-E-T is just matching the first word of our string. But I want all should be matched with our regular expression. That's why it is called as regular expression. So what I'll do, I need to analyze P is common in first letter of all these strings and T is common. So here I can write P and T, and the middle letter is changing for each word. So what I'll do, I'll just write dot. So here we can see it is matching all the words present in the string. So dot is just used for replacing one character. Now let's add more words in our string. For example, if I write here PEAT. So what do you think? This regular expression will match this PEAT? No. Why? Because we have regular expression as P dot T, and dot is just for replacing one character. And we have here PEAT. P is for this, T is for this, but we have two characters over here, so it won't be able to match with this string. Let's understand this with another example. Let's say I have chat, chit, chat, and I want to write here the regular expression which matches all the strings. So what I'll do, I'll check here C is matching, then H is matching, and then T is matching. The third letter is varying in every word. So here I can write CH dot T. So here you can see it's matching all the strings. Now if I write here CH slash T, then also it will match. If I write CH question mark T, then also it is matching. And how we are knowing that it is matching? By the blue color. As the words are matching, it is having the blue color. Now if I write here CH negate T, then also it is matching. If I write CH tab T, then also it is matching. Now if I write CH enter T, but this time it won't be matching. Though enter is just one character, but we have the condition over here. Dot wildcard can accept any character except new line. Now I have question. Let's delete this. If I have 9 rupees, I need to write in some of my program 9 rupees. So what I'll do, I can write it as 9.00. So for matching 9.00, I'll write into the regular expression so that it can match it here. And our program got into production, and someone gave the input instead of 9 rupees as 9500 or 9-00. So our input was for 9 rupees, but here it is accepting for 9500, 9-00. But I just want the 9 rupees over here. So here we can see this dot we entered as decimal point, but here it is getting wrong as the regular expression took it as wildcard. So in the case of decimal point, it will make a big mistake. So how can I get rid of it? Our escaping meta character come into use. Escaping meta character is backslash, where if I enter this backslash in front of any of the character, it will ignore this character. Now in the case of decimal point, it fixes the most common of our mistakes. If I write here backslash, it will just be taking my 9.00, which is a decimal point, and it won't be taking the other string. So this is where escape character comes into use. And there is one more very important point to note, that quotation mark are not meta characters in most of the cases, and they don't need to be escaped. Inside a regular expression, a quotation mark is usually just a regular character. Let's delete this. Now let's make 2 Python files with the name program1.py and the other one program2.py. Let's take 2 more, program3.py, program4.py, and I want a zip file where all 4 files will be placed in. So I can write program 5_py.zip because I want to know that it is a Python file. So I need to write a regular expression. So what I'll do, I'll take the first one, program1.py. As it is matching the first word of our string, let's make few changes and I'll write dot. Look at that. Now I have matched not only the first four, but also a part of fifth one, because it matches this underscore. It's a wildcard. Instead, what I want to do is put a backslash here so that it cannot match exactly the four we have. I want to have wildcard followed by a literal period. So hope you will understand what this backslash do. This is an escape character. As here, I just wanted to match up with all the Python files with the help of regular expression, not a zip file. So this is how we can get rid of making a big mistake, because in practical world, the small deeds become a big problem. And here I have used global in flags. That's why it is detecting all the words in a string. Now, if I uncheck this, it will just detect first word only. So here I'll check this global so that it can detect all the four files which are in our string. And now there is a last thing that I want to point out, opening and closing, which indicates beginning and end of our regular expression. Let's understand this with an example. Here I have some logo where I want to detect netset os, and I also have a forward slash here. So how will I write this in my regular expression? Try it out with me. Netset os, and if I write here forward slash, here you can see there is a red mark. There's a red mark over here which is showing the error, as it is taking unskipped forward slash. This may cause issues if copying or pasting this expression into code, because if my code is using the forward slash as a delimiter, so this will be the case where we want to escape it. So as to get rid of this, what I'll do, I'll go here and put escape character so that it will ignore our forward slash. As forward slash are both opening and closing of the regular expression, they are the delimiters. So this is an important thing to remember. It seems simple, but it will trip you up if you are not careful. This video is on other special characters in regex. There are few special characters that we need to consider. First, spaces. Remember, space is a character which we have discussed earlier. And if you want to match a space, then you need to put a literal space into your regular expression. This we will also discuss practically. Now, secondly, tabs. Tabs is not so simple. A tab generally indicated by backslash T. Remember this backslash we have discussed in last video? Backslash denotes escaping. T doesn't have its normal meaning. It now has a special meaning because it often referred to as control character, and it is commonly used inside string in different programming language. Then third comes line returns, where we can use backslash r, backslash n, and sometimes backslash r, backslash n together. Backslash r refers to line return, whereas backslash n refers to new line. This is quite similar, and it completely depends on operating system, where if we talk about Windows, it normally uses CR and LF. Whereas in Unix, just LF, and in Mac, CR. CR refers to carriage return, whereas LF refers to line field. Line field is backslash n cr backslash r. Okay, let's discuss this practically. I'll go to PyCharm and let's see. Yes, here we have a sort color program. So what I'll do, I'll just copy from here and we'll go to Notepad++ and I'll copy here. Here you can see CR and LF comes automatically. If it is not coming in your Notepad++, you can go to View and click on Show Symbol, where I have clicked on Show All Characters. So Show All Characters will have this CR and LF. As it is in Windows, we will get CR and LF together. Now let's see it by pressing Ctrl F. And here I'll write CR and LF. CR refers to backslash R and LF is for backslash N. Now when I press Enter, you can see a light blue color line is going on each line. See, as I'm working on Windows, so it will work with slash R and slash N. Also, if I give just slash R or rather backslash R, then also it will work. And now instead of backslash R, I'll give backslash N, then also it will work. Whereas in Unix, just backslash N will work, and coming to Mac, just backslash R will work. So you can see how similar they were. Just they are depending on operating system which we are using. So let's start with practical example. So here we are using regexr.com. Let's start with first special character space. So I'll take net out of netset os. So I'll just write in string n space e space t. Now if I have to make regular expression for n space e space t, what I can make? N space e space t, right? It's just the similar one. But instead of space, if I write dot, then also it will work fine as it is matching it up. So here it signifies a space is a character. Now let's try with another example, where I'll take n, t, and between this, I'll give backslash t. Now you can see there is a special color in backslash t. A color is changing, as this backslash is also a escaped character. And when I write backslash t, it is a tab character. Now coming downwards, let's make a text over here. Here if I write n tab t, you see it is matching. And this arrow represents tab key. This is just the choice which we have in editors. A lot of different ways. Sometimes it will just be a tiny arrow. Sometimes this symbol. So it can be anything. Now let's delete this. Now if I take C backslash N D, and here I'll write something where C is the last letter, and here I'll write D and my letters. And you can see it is matching with C and D, as backslash N refers to next line. Now instead of backslash n, if I write backslash r, here it will not match, as backslash r is a carriage return. So in this case, this is actually working with JavaScript. That's what I'm using here. So this text string is not actually in a file. So here for next line, we'll be using backslash n. So this is all about other special characters in regex. Today, we will solve an exercise where we need to apply regular expression to a text file, where we need to count number of times a word less appears. Also, we need to count cordless, emotionless, containerless, wireless in text file. With this, we need to write a regular expression for NetSetOS, GetSetGo, as well as addition and addition. And then we'll be searching this regular expression in our text file. This is our text file, and I'll attach this text file in the description below. So go through these questions and try to solve on text file. Hopefully you are completed with all question of exercise. Now I'll show you the solution that I came up with. The first question was, how many times the word less appears inside this text? And here I have copied all the text into the regexr.com, which is our regular expression tool. Now here it's very easy to do in regular expression engine, because if I type here less, it shows me 29 matches, as these literal characters occur in 29 matches. But here we can see they are all lowercase letters. Now what I'll do, I'll go to flags and here I'll click on case insensitive so that we can get uppercase letter as well. So you can see it's 34 matches. So altogether, it's 34 matches. Now the next task is to count cordless, emotionless, containerless and wireless. So first I'll count cordless. Here I'll type cordless and it shows me it's 8 matches. Let's try emotionless. It's 7 matches. Then containerless, it's 8 matches. And then wireless, it's only 3 matches. You can also try them with capital letters. Now let's go to next task, to write a regular expression for NetSetOS and GetSetGo. I'll delete this. And here I'll write the string first, NetSetOS, and the other one is GetSetGo. So first I'll copy the first one in my regular expression so that it will match the first character. Now I have to go and I'll try with dot, et is common, set is common, and the last two characters are dot. So this is the regular expression for both of them, as they are matching with both strings. Then comes addition and addition. Here I'll write addition and addition. I know addition has two D's, but to match it up, I used just one D over here. So first, I'll copy the first string, addition. And here just first character difference is there between two strings. So I'll use dot addition so that it will match both of them in the string. Now next comes what matches if we give in our regular expression t dot dot ch besides teach. So here we'll see. First I'll copy this and I'll paste over here. Here I need to see what all characters will be matching besides teach. So I'll write t dot dot ch. So here we can see teach as well as these kind of characters also, where we are just putting t space comma ch, and that is the thing we don't want. Even touch is coming, want charity out of this t space comma ch is also matching with this. So with this, I just want to say dot in regular expression sometimes harms, because it's probably something you didn't expect and it is found in middle of the words. So these are totally 6 matches. The reason I wanted you to do this exercise is I want you to see that it's really easy to pick up things when you are searching that you don't intend to. You match more than you want, like here we got. And that is really a fundamental trick of regular expressions. So after this, in the next video, I'll be coming up with character set. In this video, we will begin by learning two meta characters, open and closed square braces. It is mainly used to define a custom character set. If you remember in the last video, we discussed about t.ch, which we have defined in regular expression, and we were trying to detect the words besides teach. So we got to know this character, where it has the space, comma. In this, it is detecting all kind of characters, whether it is comma, space, colon, semicolon, as dot character allows us. Now let's delete this. And here I'll define beer as well as beer. Now if I write regular expression for it, it will be B-E-R. Now if I have to match with both of these strings, I'll make a dot over here so that it can match both these strings. Now with this, if I write here B-E-S-R, B-E semicolon R, B-E dot R, B-E space R. Now in this, I'm making a condition over here that it should not detect the punctuations between B-E and R. I just want a vowel over here. Here, I can make usage of character set, as I'll make use of square brackets, and here I'll define all the vowels A-E-I-O-U. So you can see it's just detecting the vowels and we are only having two strings. So basically it makes a tight range so that these kind of character cannot come in this. Characters, I mean to say this punctuations. I don't want commas, space, colon, semicolon, nothing. I just want vowels over here. And regular expression is all about conditions. Now let's take the other strings as sensor as well as sensor. And I want regular expression to be matching with both of them. So here I can write C and S dot R. Now here also there can be condition C and S space R, or rather C E N S comma R. I don't want that. So here I can define A E I O U for vowels. Now what if I get such condition C E N S O U R? Here these two are vowels. So why it is not detecting? The answer is, it is only a single character. So we have C-E-N-S and then square brackets O-U followed by R. It would not match the word sensor because it is always giving a single character. Even though it looks same visually, but with this we can have just a single character. So we need to be careful with this. Now let's delete this. And I'll be writing some of the strings like NetSet OS, some of the languages, Python, Java, Data Science, Perl, and more. So this is going to be text where we are going to search for our regular expression. I'll start with searching for vowel over here. So I'll write square bracket A-E-I-O-U. Right? Now you can see it is just giving me E because it is in standard mode. Now I'll go to flag and will click on global. With clicking of global, it is detecting all the vowels for our string. But if you see it carefully, it is not detecting for Java. A is not detected for a e I o u, as it is in smaller case, and a I have defined over here with uppercase. So here I can write a e I o u. So with this, it is detecting all the uppercase vowels as well as lowercase vowels. Now if I swap it, instead of a e I o, I can write o e I, it will detect the same. There will be no effect on this. Let's try out with numerical values. For that, I'll delete all these strings and here I'll write the roll numbers. Let's say Anita has roll number 1, Monica roll number 2, Devi roll number 5, Ram roll number 9. Now I got a situation where I just need to detect the numbers. Mostly in projects we used to get these kind of conditions where we need not to detect the characters, just we want the numerical value. My client asked me to just detect the numerical value. So what I'll do, I'll write the regex as hyphen. With this, I'll put square brackets and here I'll write all the numbers from 0 to 9. So this is how it is detecting all the numerical values. And here we are not getting even a single string value. So with this, I also got a name with, let's say, Sham with number, let's say, 56. So here you can see it is just detecting 5. As I have already told you, the square brackets is always detecting a single digit, not more than that. So here it is only detecting 5. Let's try out with punctuations, where I have thank you with exclamation mark, thank you with full stop, thank you, let's say semicolon. So we could come up here and make our regular expression as with square brackets, exclamation mark, full stop, semicolon, and I'll close this square bracket. So you can see it is detecting all the punctuation marks. Now let's take it more further. Till here we have discussed about character sets, where character set is just a way of defining a custom set of values that can be in any single character position. Mind it, it is single character position. And we are customizing it as per our usage. Now let's come up with character range. Character range is a very important topic which helps us a lot with character sets. Character range is denoted by hyphen, which indicates range of characters. For example, if we had a character set that was to match any number, then we usually define it by 0 to 9. And if we wanted to match any lowercase letter, then we could create a character set and put all the lowercase letters from A to Z, as like this. And for the uppercase, it's same, A to A, B, C, D, E, F, G till Y, Z. But if we wanted to have a character set that would match any uppercase letter as well as any lowercase letter with any number, then we will have to write a lot of information. First 0 to 9, then A to Z in lowercase, then in uppercase. And that too, it will be targeting a single character only. There, character range takes our pain. We use the meta character, which is just a dash, or we can say hyphen, to indicate a range of characters. This hyphen includes all characters between two characters. Let's say, if we have to define from 0 to 9, we can write it as 0 to 9. That is 0 hyphen 9. And if we have to define from A to Z in lowercase,
A to Z. And for uppercase, capital A to capital Z. Let's say in our last example where we have used Anita 1. And here I want to detect all the uppercase. So what I'll do? With brackets, capital A hyphen capital Z, I'll get all the capital letters, whether it is A, M, D, R, S. Now I want to detect all the lowercase. So what I'll do? I'll go for small a to small z. Now it can detect all the lowercase letters. Now if I want to detect all the numerical values, I can go for 0 to 9. Now let's detect all the uppercase as well as lowercase. So I can go for capital A to Z as well as small a to Z. So with this, we got all the alphabetical orders, whether it is uppercase or lowercase. But for numerical values, if I write 0 to 9, it is detecting all the numbers. Now if I write over here 56 to 99. But what is this? Here we are just getting 5 and 9. Because here regular expression plays a trick. Because if we are given 56 to 99, I'll write over here. It doesn't mean from 56 value to 99. It means 6 to 9. It's just a range of one character from 6 to 9. With this, we will have 5 and 9. That's why it is detecting 5 and 9. 4 is exceeding this limit. Between 6 to 9, we won't be able to have 4, 1 or 2. Now if I give number as 8, let's take a name Nina with 8. It is detecting it. Here it is detecting it because 8 lies between 6 to 9. So be careful, it's not a number range. It's just a range between where hyphen is lying between the numbers from 6 to 9. Now let's take another example where I have a number 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 3, 4, 5 separated by hyphen. And I'll delete this regular expression. And with this, I'll just write 0 to 9. So with this, it will be detecting all the numerical values as it is matching all of those numbers. Now here, if I want to match some numbers with a real pattern, so we could repeat this. I'll copy this and paste over here. Then again. So you can see we have covered 0 to 9 4 times as per 0, 1, 2, 3. Hyphen is used. So I'll use over here hyphen. Then again, there is 4. So I can repeat this range again. Then again, it is covering up 5. Then again, it is covering up 6 also. Then I'll put hyphen. Then I'll give the range 3 times. Now it matches the whole number. Notice here that the dash inside this character range and also a dash outside the range. This dash outside the square bracket is literal character. I have made a video on literal characters. You can check it out in my regex tutorial. But you can use the same technique to match zip codes, ID numbers, security numbers in the exact same way. So character range are a useful tool when working with character sets. Now in the next video, I'll be coming up with negative character sets. Here I'm covering up all the small topics related to regex. After that, I'll be coming up with conceptual videos on regex. This video, we will be discussing about negative meta character. Till now, we have covered character set. Last video was on character set and character range. And here I have already made
regex tutorial from part 1 to part 7. Now this is part 8. I'll recommend you, if you don't have idea of character set, please go through that and then you will easily understand negative meta character, because it will be very easy to learn after character sets. So negative meta character is denoted by negate, or we can say anything other than, and it is also said to be caret. It signifies negate a character set. For example, if I have A, E, I, O, U, which are vowels, and if I write negate in front of vowels, or I can say 0 to 9 and I'll type here negate in front of 0 to 9. Here you'll be easily getting this if you read in simple English. This is denoted by anything other than. Now if I read in simple English, tell me anything other than these characters. So it will be obviously all consonants. Right? Now let's read this statement in simple English. Anything other than 0 to 9. There is nothing, because numerical characters are just from 0 to 9. So it is a opposite of character set. Whatever character we will give here, it is negating it. Anything other than this. So it's a list of characters that can't be there. To do this, you add a negate sign as the first character, and it should be inside the character set. So it has the effect of making the entire character set into a negative set. Let's understand this with an example. Here I am using regexar tool. For this I want to give a regular expression K and O, then square brackets, and here I want to write negate B and T. As I know, with K and O, it can be knob, it can be not, but I have a requirement in my project that these two words should not be there in string. Basically, regex is always used in string handling. So if I give the word no, it is taking it, because it says it could be anything other than B and T, but it will be taking one character. So if I'll write knob, here it will not take. Now if I write K and O, let's see whether it will take. Yes, it is taking it. Then if I write K and O semicolon, yes. Then K and O full stop, yes. And K and O space, still it is taking. So here we need to be careful. So here the negative character set is still looking for a character, whether it is semicolon, full stop or space, because those are still considered characters. So just be thoughtful when you use it. Now let's go to Google, and I want a list of strings. So I'll just type boy, and let's copy this all lyrics and I'll paste over here. Now what I'll do, I'll type here in regular expression bracket and inside this A to Z. Now you can see each and every letter which are in lowercase has been matched with a string. But this B, which is in uppercase, Y, A are not been matched, because these are in uppercase. Except this, there are spaces, apostrophe, which are not being matched. Now what I'll do, I'll write here negate. So it gets opposite to it. Now it's tracking all the uppercase as well as the punctuations, including space, apostrophe,
everything. Now what I'll do, I'll type A to Z also. It should be capital Z. Such that it is taking A to Z with uppercase and lowercase, but we have written here negate. That means opposite of it. So here it is just tracking all the spaces and the punctuations. Today we will see how we can use meta characters inside character set. Most meta characters inside character sets are already escaped. That is, they are going to have their literal meaning. They are not going to be considered meta characters. So you don't need to escape them again. For example, if we have a regular expression as C and then a character set followed by T. And in this character set, we have letter A so as to make cat. And here I'll add dot inside the character set. Here this dot is a literal character. It's not a meta character. So if I match C dot T, it will be able to match the string. But if we have this dot outside C dot T, I can write anything over here. Cat, C semicolon T, C space T. But if I define this dot inside a character set, it won't be able to match this, because inside this character set it will be treated as literal. Here I can write C dot T, then only it will match. Otherwise, if we have C space T, C semicolon T, it won't be able to take it. Now here if I add A, you have seen the CAT is automatically matching with it, because inside the character set it always takes one single character. So here it took A and here it took dot. Then the other point, the exceptions. Inside character set there are four exceptions. We know we can use dash for ranges. As we have discussed in last video, if we use this dash inside the character set, let's say from 0 to 9, it will be ranging from 0 to 9. And when we use caret, it is used to negate. If I use negate 9, then I won't be able to match 9 character. So they have special meanings. Dash is for character range, caret for negative character sets. If we want to use literal dash or literal caret, then you need to use it literally. If we are using literal dash or literal caret, then you need to escape those. Let's understand this with an example. I'm deleting this. Now here, if I write int in square brackets 9, then I'll take int curly braces 9, int parenthesis 9. Basically, regex is used in compiler, where they used to detect all the brackets. If we are missing it, then as per regex, they give the error. Now we need to write regex for this. So what I'll do, I'll copy this and I'll paste over here. Now, so as to match these three string, what I'll do? I'll write over here dot on both places so that it will match three of the strings. Let's make a range for this. For dot, it can take anything, space, punctuations, and I don't want that. So what I'll do, I'll make a character set, and inside the character set, I'll define first square bracket, then curly braces and parenthesis. Just the opening of the all braces. I'll ignore this dot. So till here, it's working well. Now we have to work for closing braces. So for this, I'll make a character set. And here, I'll define first parenthesis. It's taking it. Then curly braces. It is also taking it and matching the strings. Now let's apply
square brackets. So you have seen, as soon as I have given the square bracket, it is not matching any of them because it is taking the closing of character set. That's why square bracket is exception of meta characters inside character sets. Square bracket is one of them. Now we need to do something, otherwise we won't be able to match this here. So as to match it, I need to escape it. We have read escape character in meta characters. Just we need to put backslash. Now you can see, after putting this backslash, it is ignoring it and treating it as a literal character so that it can match. So we have understood this exception, why this square bracket is an exception. Now let's see other three. So we will prefer by examples. So for this, we need to go to RegExR tool, and here I'll delete everything. Let's write bunch of words here. So I'll start writing by program 01, program dash 1, program backslash 1, and then program underscore 1. Here we have four words. Now let's write a regex for it. So we can see we have program common in every word as well as one at the end. So I'll write program and then one. Here there is one letter difference in every word. So I'll write dot so as to match every word in the string. So this dot is matching 0, dash, backslash and underscore. But here I have a condition. This dot should only match these four characters, not more than that. But if I am putting this dot over here, and if I'll write program space one, here it is matching and I don't want that. So for this, what I'll do, I'll make a character set and will define all the characters in it, whether it is 0, dash, backslash, underscore. I'll delete this for the time being. Now we can see it's taking 0, backslash and underscore, but it is not taking this dash. This is because this dash comes under exception. As we have read here, dash comes under exceptions. But I have a requirement that I need to include this dash. So what I'll do? I'll use here backslash so that it will escape it and will treat it as a literal character. So here I'll use backslash. But now it is not taking the other backslash. So here I need to again give a backslash so as to match every word of our strings. Here if you notice, these backslashes we usually use in Windows when we make use of copying the address. Remember, while in Linux we use single forward slash, but in Windows if we use single backslash, it asks us to give additional backslash so as to work properly. Let's discuss this in the next video. I'll make a separate video on this. But remember how important regex is. So in this tutorial, we will understand each and every concept of regex. So hope you are following me. Now back to our topic. Here we have seen all four exceptions which are used in character set. And so as to make use of it, we make use of escape character, as we have seen through examples. So you can play around on your own with adding, removing some of the escapes to see how they work. Now let's see how shorthand character sets works in regular expression engines. They are very useful as they save us from typing. So here I'll write bunch of words. Let's say netset os underscore 1234 java dash 98 python underscore 345, 38 underscore javascript. Let's take net set space 1234 OS. Now I have a requirement that I need just numerical value over here. So we know it. We can simply make a character set and write 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. It is matching all the numerical values. Let's make it short. Why to make it so much long? So here I can write 0 to 9. Still it is doing the same. Now I want the shorter form of it. So what I'll do, I'll simply define backslash d. See, with this we are getting all the numerical values over here. Now let's write it also. Backslash d is used for matching all the numerical values. Now here I want to match all the alphabets. So I can write from A, B, C, D to till Z, so that it will track all the alphabets in lowercase from A to Z. Now here let's make it short. I can write it as A dash Z. So it is taking from A to Z, but it is taking only lowercase. So I'll define capital A to capital Z. So it's just taking all the alphabets, both lowercase and uppercase. Let's have numerical value also here. So I can define 0 to 9. So with this, we got all the numerical values as well as alphabets, whether it is in lowercase as well as uppercase. Now here we also have underscore. So we can define underscore also. Now let's make it short. Here we can make use of backslash w, where it will match all the numerical values, all the alphabets, whether it is in uppercase or lowercase. With this, it will take underscore also, as we have defined over here. So I'll take backslash w. So you can see it's matching all the characters, whether it is num, uppercase or lowercase alphabets, with this underscore also. So you can see it's a quite bit less typing. Now here if I want space to be tracked, as it is not detecting over here, so I'll write backslash s. Backslash s is used for white spaces between characters. So here we got to know backslash d, which is used for numerical values, backslash w for numerical alphabets, whether it is in uppercase or lowercase, as well as underscore. Then comes backslash s, which is used for matching all the spaces. Now let's write backslash d, which is used for matching all the numerical values. Now if I write over here negate, so it will trace all the values except numerical value. So instead of writing caret backslash d, we can write backslash capital D, which means anything but not digits. Same with backslash w. If I write negate, it is similar to backslash capital W. It means anything but not small w. Small w, which has alphabets including uppercase, lowercase, nor numerical value, nor underscore. It will have everything except these. Then we have discussed space. If we keep negate to it, it is equivalent to backslash capital S, which means anything but not spaces. So backslash D is opposite of backslash small d, that is negate of this. Let's see with practical example, because understanding with practical example gives us a clear understanding. So here, instead of writing negate backslash d, I can write backslash capital D. It's taking the same characters but not numerical one. Now
we have discussed backslash w. It is taking alphabets, numerical number, underscore. And if I apply neget to this, it is just matching space and dash. Now if I write backslash capital W, it's taking the same. Now with this, we will take backslash small s. It's just taking space. Now if I apply neget to this, by the way, neget is on 6 key, if you see in your keyboard. Now with this, it is taking all the things but not space. So with this, if you have observed, underscore is a word character, but it was not taking hyphen. This dash was neither in W nor in D, neither in space. So hyphen is not a word character. You are not sure? Let's see it once again. Here if I write backslash W, it is taking all the characters, numerical, uppercase, lowercase alphabets, underscore, but it is not taking hyphen and not a space. So we can say hyphen is not a word character. Understood? So here let's discuss some caution when we are working with shorthand, especially backslash W. So we have to remember this backslash W is used for lowercase, uppercase, numerical, with this underscore also. That's why we always refer underscore as a word character. And especially if we are looking at the words which are text in a book, we are not expecting that it is to be included. But we need to remember that regular expressions are primarily a tool for programmer. And if you have a variable name, file name, or an underscore, it is commonly used character in that context. While hyphen is not a word character. And that we need to keep in mind thoroughly. Now let's write bunch of years. Starting from 2020, I'll take 2022. Now here I need to match four numbers. So here I'll start writing by backslash D, then backslash D, then backslash D. You can see it has two matches with three numbers. And when I write backslash D once again, it will match all of the four digits. Now let's try another example. Here I'll take bunch of numerical values. Let's say 4567 space 8754, then space T dash E dash X. And here I'll delete this. Here I'll define a character set and make it backslash D so as to match up with numerical values. So here we will get all the digits. Now for matching the space, I can write backslash S. So here we got all the digits with spaces. And if I want just the spaces, I can take out backslash D so as to get only spaces. Now with this backslash D, if I put here negate, so it neither has digits, numerical values, nor space. So what is left? The hyphen as well as alphabet. So in this case, it is going to be the letters T-E-X. And if you see it carefully, why is it matching this? Because we have used neget of digit. So these are not digits nor spaces. These are just letters and also the hyphen. So letter and hyphens are neither of spaces nor digit. So up to here, you are very confident with shorthand characters as well as how to use meta characters inside the character set. Now it's time for the next exercise, exercise number 2. In this exercise, we are going to be using everything that we have just learned. So for this exercise,
We need to write a regular expression that matches both the word happy and nappy. Yeah, I forgot. Here I'll be providing a text file for this exercise 2, which we'll be using to write a regular expression. That will be provided in the description below, so you can refer this. So the first point, you need to write a regular expression that matches both the word happy and nappy. Secondly, write a regular expression that matches feel but not feels. Then the third, write a regex to match the digit and the period. For example, you need to match this 1 dot, 2 dot, 3 dot and 4 dot. And any other number should not be matched with this. Then fourthly, write a regex to find 18 character word that starts with F. So whichever word with 18 characters has been used in this text file, you need to find out. So you can pause the video, take some time to work, and then go through the solutions that I'll be coming up with. So pause the video now. Hopefully you did well in this exercise. If you got stuck, don't worry. I'm going to walk you through and show you the answers that I came up with. So I'll go to my regex tool and I'll copy this text file to the regex. Now the first question was, write a regular expression that matches both the word happy and nappy. So here I have to match happy and also nappy. Happy has been matched with this. Now if I write the word here, happy and also nappy. So for regex, all letters are same except this H and N. So except first letter, all the letters will be there. So here I'll write a character set where I'll mention H and N. Instead of this, I would have put dot also, but I want to make a range, just happy and nappy, nothing other than that. So here we can see, if you scroll down here, it is matching happy as well as nappy. So the first question solved. Now comes the second question, write a regular expression that matches feel. So we need a regex to match feel but not feels. So here if I write feel, it is matching with feel everywhere, but this feels is not being traced. So what I'll do, I'll make use of neget here. So if I write neget s, so here you can see it's tracing feel but not feels. Here you can see it's not matching at all. But the problem we are facing here, it is also taking space with this, and that we don't want. So this we will solve in the later videos. But right now, feel has been tracked but not feels. So second question solved. Now comes the third question, write a regex to match the digit and the period. Period refers to dot over here. So first I need a number here. So what I'll do, I'll write backslash D so that it can track all the numbers, then a dot. But dot will be tracking other number as well, because dot here is a wildcard character. We want to make sure that we escape it to make it a literal period. So here I'll write backslash dot. So this is now a literal period, literal dot. Now there are exactly 4 matches, 1 dot, 2 dot and 3 and 4 dot. So question 3 solved. Now comes write a regex to find 18 character word that starts with F, and then we should have 18 character. So here what I'll do, I need to write F, then we can use slash W so as to match all the characters which are left in 18 words. So it will be 17 times. So here you can see the only word starting with F is this. So we are able to find 18 character word starting from F by using this character set. Though this solution works for us, let's improve this in our next video, where I'll be coming up how to improve our repetition method to avoid this. In this video, we will learn how to use repetition in our regular expressions. And trust me, this will help us to write more complex patterns. So there are three repetition meta characters which we need to learn here. First, asterisk, then plus sign, and then question mark. All three of them are going to go in a regular expression. And here we can control the repetition with the help of these three meta characters. So first, if we use asterisk, then the item will be repeated either 0 times or more. So it's completely optional. It may be there for 1 time, 2 time, 3 time, or infinite number of times. If we are using plus sign, then the item must exist at least once, but it could be repeated as many times. And then the third one, the question mark, says the item would exist either 0 or 1 time. So you can also think of it as being optional. It may be there or it may not be there, but it can't be repeated any more than 1 time. So let's understand this with the help of example so as to understand it clearly. First, we'll start with asterisk. So for this, I'll go to R tool, regex R tool. Now here, let's take oranges. And my keyboard has some problem due to which it left oranges, then oranges, and oranges. So while typing, I got this error in my paragraphs where it is orange or oranges, oranges, or triple S or four time S. But I don't want that it should come into error. So for this, I need to write a regex which should match all of the words in a string. So I'll start with first string, orange. So it's just matching the first word in the second word till orange. S is not matching. That means S is optional. Now we have to think in a way where asterisk is taking for 0 time or more, plus for 1 or more, and question mark 0 or 1. Now in a string, we have orange, oranges, oranges. That means there is a probability of S that it can be 0 or more. So here I won't be using plus sign. Now I need to choose between asterisk and question mark. But my choice is more than 1. So I'll go for asterisk over here so that S probability in oranges can be 0 times or more times. So here I can write S asterisk so that it will match all the words in a string. So with this, we knew the usage of asterisk. Now let's take the words as happy birthday with an exclamation mark, then happy anniversary with another exclamation mark. Let's say happy Holi, and then happy Diwali. Now I have to write such a regex so that all the words can be matched with it. Now when I think about this, I can write it as first happy as it is matching all the words, or let's start with happy birthday first. Here I'll write happy birthday and then I'll match it up with happy anniversary and then happy Holi and then happy Diwali. But here happy is matching in all the words. So I'll delete the word which is not matching as it has the difference of birthday, anniversary, Holi, Diwali. And happy and exclamation mark are common in every string. So I'll delete out of this. Until here we know the usage of dot. Dot is used for each character. So here I'll write after space dot dot dot. Holi is matching now, but I want birthday to be matched. Now we got birthday also. But the problem I'm facing over here that I can't put dot because it has different length. Anniversary is longer length. Holi is just 4 length word and Diwali is 6 length word. So here what can I do? I can go for plus, because plus is the word where we can repeat for one or more. As we have seen, happy and space are common in all of the 4 strings. So I'll leave it as it is. Now what I'll do, I'll take one dot as it is used in 4 of these strings and then I'll apply plus sign. See, by applying plus sign, it is matching all of the words. And here as exclamation, we'll be using as literal word. So here I'll apply backslash and now it is matching all the words of different length. So see how useful it is. Now let's see with more couple of examples. If I write the year names 1984 with October, 1968 November, 2020 May. Now here I have a requirement of detecting all the numerical values. So you know, for numerical values we can use backslash d. So here it is detecting 1 by 1. Here we can see it is detecting 12 matches. To avoid this, I'll go for backslash d, then backslash d as it is detecting 3 matches. Then I'll go for backslash d again. So with this we got 3 matches only and we have detected all the numerical values out of this. But to write backslash d every time, it's not possible because here digits are same. What if I write here, let's say 7 8 3 8 9 9, I'll take another one 6 7 3 9 9 5 5. Now here we can see sometimes 7 8 is left, 9 is left, 5 is left. And there are 9 matches and there is no such requirement here and this is looking so clumsy. So what we can do, we can make use of repetition meta characters. Here I can go for the same plus, which is used for one or more. So instead of writing each backslash d so many times, I can go for plus. See, as soon as I have written plus, it has given me 4 matches as there are 4 numerical values and it is detecting each with whatever length of word we are giving, it is accepting it. So here we have seen the usage of asterisk plus. Now let's see usage of question mark, how it can be used in our day-to-day life. As you must be remembering the site name Grammarly, we usually make use of it to write for the offer letters or for the letter to the colleague for some kind of official usage. So as to get confident whether we are not using any wrong spellings or a wrong grammar, we generally make use of Grammarly. So here comes the word color and
Sometimes we use the word color, C-O-L-O-U-R. Both spellings are right because it varies as per the geographical area. Both spellings are right. But how Grammarly recognizes it? Here it makes usage of regex. Where comes question mark? Question mark is used for 0 or 1. Let's see how. If I write color, the first word is matched. Now if I write color, then the second string is matched. So what I'll do, there's a difference of U over here. So I'll make use of question mark so that if U is used, then also it's okay. If U is not used, then also it's okay. So here with U, I'll write question mark. See, now it's matching both of the string. So it makes our work so easy that we can easily recognize both. Repetition meta characters allows us to have matches of infinite repetition. So it can match 1 time, 2 time, 3 time, 4 time, it doesn't really matters. It makes the repetition meta characters a very useful tool for writing regular expressions. After learning repetition meta characters, now let's talk about quantified repetition. In repetition meta character, we have learned about asterisk, which is for 0 or more times, plus for 1 or more times, question mark for 0 or 1 time. But what if we want something very specific? Specific quantity? Let's say I want to repeat something exactly 5 times. Or we want to repeat it specifically 4, 5 or 6 times. That's where quantified repetition comes in. Here we have the ability to specify the number of times specifically which is to be repeated. So here we make use of curly braces with some values inside that indicates quantified repetition. So the previous item will be repeated a certain number of times. So first is to be curly braces. And here we put the values within which interval values are allowed to be repeated. So here it follows this format where we have curly braces and the first value will be minimum and the last value will be maximum. And the important point is minimum must always be included in this interval. It can be 0 also. And maximum value can be optional. So here it follows 3 syntaxes. First, the regular expression where we define D within the range 5 and 9. Where 5 is minimum and 9 is maximum. In this example, the regular expression will match numbers with 5 to 9 digits. Then comes second syntax where we will have, let's say, 1 digit. So here min will be only maximum. That means it will return just 1 value because maximum would be assumed to the same as minimum. So here it will matches the number with exactly 5 digits. And the third syntax, when we have 5, comma, and there is no maximum value. So here we provide minimum value and the comma. But we don't mention a maximum value. So in this case, maximum value will be assumed as infinite. So if we have 5, comma, that means 5 or more. Let's understand this with an example for which I have 1 dot space A, 2 dot AB, 3 dot space ABC, 4 dot ABCD, 5 dot space ABCDE, 6 space, here it will be ABC, A, B, C, D, E, F, 7 dot space A, B, C, D, E, F, G, 8 dot space A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. That's enough.
Now, here we need to write a regular expression. So, how will I write here? First, we have digits. So, I can write backslash D. Then we have dot over here. So, I need to give a literal character, which should be given with backslash dot, then a space. Now, we have number of characters. So, I can define it as, let's say, backslash W with plus as per repetition character. And then I'll give a space, as I have given space everywhere. Now here, let's make usage of quantified repetition, where instead of plus, if I'll give first curly braces and I want from 2 to 5, the characters AB, which is 2, and ABCDE to 5. So it has matched all the strings which has the character from 2 to 5. Now instead of 5, if I write 8, it is returning me from 2 to 8. Either we can use 1 to 7, it is returning 1 to 7. Now after this, let's see if I give just one number within the curly braces. So I'll give 5. It is matching the string which is exactly 5 digits, 5 characters. Now if I give here 7 character string, 4 character string, where minimum is assumed to be maximum. Now what if I give 4 comma? Here it assumes the maximum value to be infinite, or whatever the last value over here. So minimum value is 4 and the last value is 8, whichever the largest value is. So after seeing quantified repetition, we can say regular repetition and quantified repetition. Between these, we have a wide range of ability to specify how many times something will be repeated in a pattern. Though in quantified repetition, we can give a specific repetition number. But still, if I relate this quantified repetition with regular repetition, I can say from 0 to infinite as asterisk. As we have read, in asterisk section, asterisk matches from 0 or more. It is also doing the same. If we have 0 or more, we can simply say D asterisk. Also, if it is 1 or more, we can say plus, because plus signifies returns 1 or more, right? So if I use 1 as minimum and maximum as infinite, it is same as plus repetition operator. If 0 is minimum and maximum is infinite, it is assumed as to be asterisk repetition operator. Now here, if I take 91 and 10 digits phone number, 2, 4, 6, 6, 7, 8, let's make this 9, and let's write one more number, 91, one more, 91, starting with 9. So we have these 3 sets of numbers. Now here I have to write a regular expression, as it is a digit. So we need to give backslash D. Here it is matching all the numbers, but to be very specified, it should be backslash D, then slash backslash D, backslash D, and it should be 10 digits, right? Now making use of quantified repetition, I can write specifically by curly braces to And here I can write curly braces 10. And we have here 3 matches. So this is all about quantified repetition. But I want to mention one thing at last, that if you want to master regex, you need to practice, practice and practice. Because regex simply makes the basics. It is a basic of programming. So I'll recommend you to go through this tutorial, as it is a very basic, and without practice we can't master it. In this video we won't be discussing any concepts. Rather, in this video I'll be coming up with greedy expression, which is an important principle of how regular expression actually works. In data structure algorithm, we have discussed backtracking algorithm, and soon I'll be coming up with greedy algorithm. So if you are aware of greedy algorithm, there it tries to have longest possible strings. The same happens in regex also. It works on two principles. First, the expressions in greedy tries to match longest possible strings. With one expression, they tries to match as long possible string they can. So with single string, they tries to achieve overall match. So this greedy expression completely works on these two principles. It tries to have as much as longest possible string they can cover. If they get the chance, with single string, they can achieve overall match. Let's see how. We will understand this with an example where we have the situation to write a regex for quotes text. So for quotes text, that means if we take the example, Netset OS. And this is in quotes. So if we try to write its regex, how we can write? First, the quotes, the starting quotes, then Netset OS. We can cover it with dot plus, so that if I have dot for N, dot for E, dot for T, as we are not aware of what kind of string we are taking. So I have taken dot and the plus, plus is for one or more. And then our quotes ends here. Generally, we'll write this regex for any quotes text. So generally, we will get dot plus in quotes. So this will be our regex. Now, what I'll do, I'll divide this regex into 3 parts. First, starting quotes. Dot plus in our part 2 and the ending quotes in part 3. Till now we have seen for a word. Now I have been given a sentence where I have to detect this regex. And my assumption is that I'll get Shyam and the other word as Ram. So let's find out how it works with greedy method. So first, our arrow is at H. Right now, we'll be finding the first part of regex, which is quotes. So it will try to search the quote first. First, our arrow is at H. Then for I, no, it is not there. Then S, no. Likewise, it will be searching it throughout the sentence so that it can find out the quotes. B-R-O-T-H-E-R, no. But as soon as it finds quote over here, it will say, I got a match. And as I told you, for the single string, it tries to achieve overall match. So the second time, our arrow will move to S and will try to find out whether this quote will be covering this S due to its greedy nature. but it says no. Quotes won't be covering any other string. It just covered the quotes, right? So now after getting quotes, it will move to dot plus and will start looking for its string. So here dot plus is covering S, then H, Y, A, M. But as soon as the arrow comes on quotes, this dot plus has a greedy nature. It will say whether I can cover this quotes also. As dot covers everything. Dot can be for any kind of punctuation, whether it is semicolon, colon, or quotes. So it will cover quotes also. And again, it will go further. Now dot plus is covering space, then and, then space, now quotes comes. And this statement asks whether we should stop here. But this dot plus has a greedy nature. It says I can cover everything. Dot covers quotes also. So it will again move to R, A, M. Now as soon as this quotes will come, it says no, I can cover this also. And the arrow will move forward. And now it will cover A, R, E, then space and then friends. But now the strings finish up. And now it remembers that part 3 is still empty. It hasn't covered anything. So this time it says, okay, you can also cover. Otherwise, it will not be a complete match. So now backtracking will start. This quotes will start looking for the quotes. But S is not a quote. Now the backtracking will start and arrow will shift to D. Then N, E, I, R, F, E, R, A. Till now, no quotes are there. Now, as soon as it comes to this quotes, there is a match. And here we will get Sham and Ram as our greedy expression. But when we were starting for regex, our expectation was just the Sham and the other one Ram out of this complete string. But due to greedy nature of regex, it will cover from Sham and Ram as its string. So this is a principle of greedy expressions. Here I have taken the string as page 29867. So when we have to write its regex, our expectation will be page will be the dot, dot plus, and the numerical value will be D, which is covering from 0 to 9. Normally, we'll be writing this regex for covering this string so that it can match up here. Now, let's see how greedy nature of regex will accept it or reject it. Let's find out. So, first, for dot plus, it will start with P. Here it will accept it. So here it matches with P. Now dot plus will cover P, then A, G, then E, space. Now here we'll be having confusion. As soon as this number appears, this D will be covering this. But due to greedy nature of regex, it will say, no, I don't want you to cover. Why you are appearing? I can cover everything. Because here with single regex, they try to achieve overall match. So with dot plus, because any numerical value comes under dot also. So it says, okay, I'll move forward and you can cover with dot only. So with 9, yes, it is covering. Then 8, it is covering. Then 6, it is covering. Then 7. But as soon as 7 appears, It says, no, it cannot be a complete match without last digit of our regex. Now, backtracking will start. And this last digit will appear and match it up with D. So, page 2986 will match it up with dot plus and 7 will match up with D plus. So, we will know how to solve this kind of things with the help of lazy match. Now, we have learned about greedy expressions where it shows the default behavior of regular expression engine. So, let's know what is lazy expression. Lazy expressions are the opposite of greedy expression. It triggers and changes the default behavior. Here we use question mark, which is a meta character. If you remember, we have been using meta character question mark, but it was for different purpose. It was for 0 or 1, and that was an optional. Here, we are going to use the same meta character, but its context is going to be different here. Let's understand this with an example. But before that, we should know in how many contexts we can use question marks. First, asterisk question mark, and this is going to be meta character, indicating something which should be 0 or 1. Then comes plus question mark. Here, it is going to indicate that it should use the lazy behavior. Then comes a quantifier, min, max. With this, we can use question mark. And the fourth one, two question marks. Now, when we talk about lazy expression, it means lazy strategy, which matches little as possible. While greedy strategy was to take as much as possible. But when it comes to lazy, it tries to give up as quick as it can. Let's understand this with an example. Here, I'll take the same. His brother Shyam and Ram are friends. And I need to take out the words with quotes. So my expectation is Shyam and Ram. Let's see how lazy expression works. So first, I have given this question mark. And then we will see where quotes come. So first, we have looked for H. It was not there. For I, S, space, then brother. No quotes are there. As soon as the quotes match, here it has the strategy to give up as quickly as it can. It wants, okay, my quotes has came. Now, this circle should be given to dot plus so that this Shyam can be handled with dot plus. So, dot plus took the responsibility and it is matching Shyam. Y-A-M. It is matching it. When the quotes come, it says, I don't want to handle it. So, this was taken by this quotes. And here we got the word Shyam. Simply opposite of greedy expressions. Now again, it says maybe other word I can get which are in quotes. So it starts searching for quotes. So and doesn't have. Now as soon as quotes comes, it matches. And it says take it. I'm giving up here. So Ram is handled by dot plus. But when it is at R, actually it's a lazy one. It says I can handle till Ram, but as soon as quotes come, you handle. So Ram was okay, but when quotes comes, it hands over to the quotes, and with this we got Ram. So till now we got Ram and Shyam. And these were the words we actually wanted. So this is how lazy strategy works. Let's understand this with the same example of page 29867, where it has same dot plus, but So as to signify lazy, we have added question mark. Now dot plus is taking page. Now dot plus says, as soon as digit comes, I'll give up and you take the responsibility. So when 2 comes, it simply comes to D so that it will handle all the digits. And thereby, here we get 29867 to the digits, that is D, and all the letters are handled by dot plus question mark. So simply, it's all about directing the regular expression engine so that it knows when it comes to those choices, how do you want to make a choice? It's a very basic topic for regex. And to understand this better, I'll recommend you to practice as much as you can, as it is used in several fields. So hope you like it and you will practice. And if you face any problem in understanding regex, or you are stuck between in any of the questions or in any of your projects, you can let me know through the comment section. I will try to answer each and everything related to topic. So hope you like it. And the next, I'll be coming up with an exercise. Try to answer it. If you're stuck somewhere, I'll give you the solutions in the end of the video. So do give a try. Okay, we are ready with exercise 3. Let's test ourselves. How much we have learned till now? Basically, I have made this exercise till repetition. So let's start. So here I have made a text file specifically for exercise number 3. So the first thing, as per the text file, and don't worry about the text file, I'll give you the link which is in description below. So the first thing, we have to make a regular expression which can match over careful, beautiful, disrespectful, unsuccessful, and awful in text file. Basically, the words lasting with full. Then the second question, match both words life and live. Then the third question, find word with capital H which should have 11 letters, specifically 11 letters. And the fourth question, so match all text inside quotation marks. So take your time. If you're stuck, don't worry. I'll also discuss solution to this exercise. So countdown begins. Pause the video. Hopefully you have solved all questions. Now we will discuss solution to our exercise. So the first question was to match these words. Here I have the text in notepad. I'll copy this and paste over here. And we'll remove this exercise 3. Now we need to find out the words lasting with full. There are so many words over here, but specifically 5 words. Beautiful is covering, but I want the complete word over here. So what I'll do, I'll make use of backslash W. Backslash W is covering all the alphabets, whether it is uppercase, lowercase, and also the numbers. But here we don't want numbers. So I'm making use of backslash W and with this plus sign, so that whatever the length of the word will be, it will accept it. So we got beautiful, disrespectful, unsuccessful, overcareful, and the awful. So first question solved. Now the second question is, make a regex which can match both life and live. So in regex, I can write life, which is matching all the life words. Now what should I do? Here the difference is L-I-F-E, L-I-V-E. So the difference is basically F and V.
This we have already covered in part number 7, character set and character range. Hopefully you are following me. From first part up to here, I have made 13 parts. So you can refer it. Here I have came up with pace so that you can understand this topic very carefully. So back to the question. So as to match life and live, this is the area where we can fill F and V. And character range has the property that out of these, it will take just one. We have already discussed, remember? So here it is approaching for life. When I scroll up, there is live, then life. So with this, we are getting two words. So question two, solved. Now comes the third question. Find word with capital H with its 11 letters. Let's see. So here I need to write capital H, but including this capital H, it should be 11 letters. 11 letters. That means backslash W. Where it can have all the letters, including both cases, upper and lower. And then, including H, it's 11 letters. So here, I'll write the exact 10 letters in quantifiers. Let's see. Here we got happinesses. Bingo. So third question, solved. Now comes the fourth question. Match all text inside quotation mark. Recently I have solved this. Let's have an approach how to solve this. So for having quotes, let's put the quotes over here, and it can be of any size, it can be of any letter we are not aware of. So I can go for wildcard and with plus sign so that it can approach one or more. So as soon as I give this, it's giving me live your life. But however we want is not to be included in this. Let it be. I just want the specific live your life. Then let it be. I don't want the words outside of the quotes. I just want the words which are inside of the quotes. Hope you remember this is our greedy approach. So we need to go for lazy approach. For lazy approach, we need to put question mark. We have discussed this in our last video where we have discussed greedy versus lazy approach. For detailed version, refer it. Now, as soon as I have put question mark, here it is giving live your life. That's what I want. Let it be the exact words inside the quotes. So hopefully you answered these questions. And if you don't, just go through it and then answer these questions once again. As rejects is the topic which makes our base. So go through it and master it. And if you face any problem, let me know in the comment section below. In this video, we will learn how to group meta characters and also alternation. So for grouping meta characters, we need to know the symbols. The simple parentheses are used for grouping. So why grouping is needed? As anything inside of them will be considered as grouped expression. And here we are going to use those parentheses to group portions of the expression so that we can use them in couple of different ways, like for matching and replacing. This we will do with the help of RegExR tool. As I have discussed every point practically, I will also discuss this practically. Then the second way, to apply repetition operators to a group. It becomes very easy if we need to apply any repetition operator. For example, if I have to make into is for one or more, on two or three variables. Let's say AB.
So we can apply this into this repetition operator easily to this grouped expression. And the third way, to create a group of alternation expressions. This we will know after some time. So if we take the literal characters, let's say ABC, ABC, AB, ABC, ABC, then BAC, ABC, ABC, ABC. Let's take CAB also. And here I'll take ABC in grouping. So here we can make a group using parentheses. Now I want ABC 5 times. So I can easily write with the help of quantifiers. As we have already read, by curly braces 5, and when it comes to matching, it is not matching any one of them because we don't have any ABC 5 times. Now it matched it because here we have the group of ABC 5 times. But if I'll do the same thing, let's say BAC, 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 that too 5 times, it won't be taking it because it wants this grouped operation 5 times. And also we can apply one of the repetition operator, let's say plus, to repeat the group of characters over and over again. ABC plus is matching ABC, ABC out of ABC, AB, because we don't have the complete expression over here. Now we have ABC 2 times, but we have full expression, that is ABC. So it has matched and this will also be getting matched. You see, the same characters are being repeated. It's not just single character. It's just been repeated, which we were doing before. Now it's just group of characters that's being repeated. And it's just not limited to just literal characters. You can have anything else inside the regular expression. For example, if I use here group and ungroup, you can give a try to write a regular expression which can match both of them. So how we can do? Here I can see there is a difference of UN. So what I'll do, I'll take this UN as a group and will put question mark. If you remember, question mark was used if we want the character to be 0 times or 1 time. So here UN we don't want, and we want here 1 time. So I can make use of question mark over here. And if I write group, now you can see it's matching both of these strings. Now if I take the word live and lives, here just there is a difference of S. So if I need to make a regular expression for this, I can simply write live and with this S question mark. It's matching both of them. But if we write S in brackets, it increases our readability. And we can easily recognize that S is the optional one. Now let's understand this in more broader way. Let's take the sample card number. It can be 4587-567-1267-8763. Card number is always of 16 numbers and they are divided into 4-4. So basically I can write as D of 4, then dash, and it is matching this card number. Now, so as to make difference, what I'll do, I'll just reduce 7 from here so as to make 3. Now, let's make grouping over here of 2 to
so that we can easily understand this. Now we have a group of 1 and this is a group of 2. Right? Now I'll go to my RegexR tool and will click on the right side replace. I'll write $1. If you can see, it is representing $1, which is R4587-456. Now here, if I give $2, it is giving the other two numbers of second group. The first group as $1 and $2 as second group. Now if I need to write here, this is my debit card number, colon $1, colon $2. See, it's taking it. Here we can replace it as per our wish, where we have this as $1, the first group, and this second $1 as second group. Here I'll make 1-1 group, so that here we will have 4 groups in total. Now here in tools, if I'll ask for $1, it will just return me the first pair as 4587. Similarly for 2, it is giving 456. Let's take a problem. Somebody mistakenly has replaced this 4 and first group with each other. And this is for 10,000 documents. And it happened mistakenly. And he's not aware of it. Instead, he is getting $1 as 8763. $2 as 456. It's good to go. $3, 1267. And $4 as 4587. And now, he's facing the error. Because any of the 10,000 cards are not working. So how we can correct it? Simply by going to replace option, and we can write $4 first, then $2, then $3, and then $1. So this problem can easily be solved with the help of grouping, and you can replace it easily. As we have seen, it is helping in so many fields. Many regular expression engines allows us to use the dollar sign to refer to those capture groups. Some of them use backslash. So if dollar sign doesn't work for you, you might also try a backslash in front of the number and see if that works. Now we know how to use groups to apply repetition operators and to capture for finding and replacing it. So the next thing, we will know how to use them for alternation. So here I listed 3 use cases for grouping meta characters. First, to apply for repetition operators. Second, alternation. This we'll be going to learn now. And the third one, for capturing regular expression for replacing it. Now we'll be seeing alternation. Here, alternation meta character is represented with the help of upright bar or pipe. If you see in your keyboard, it is on the right side above the return key, or it can be above backslash. It depends on the keyboard you are using it. Alternation meta character is always treated as OR operator. It matches the expression first on left and then on right. But leftmost expression gets the preference. And group alternation expressions keep them distinct. Let's see how. Let's understand this with the help of example. Let's take television and radio. And here we can see there is no similarity. So how we can write a regular expression for it so that it can match both of these strings? So for this, we can make use of alternation operator. So I'll make a grouping character, and with this, television and the upright bar, and then comes radio. So here we can see it matches either the television or radio, either the left expression or the right expression. Let's take one more example. Here I'll take sound sleep and better sleep. For writing a regular expression, you need to test it around 100 of things. Then only you will get a better regular expression. That's why in this tutorial, I'm coming with several examples so that you can understand it and can make use of it in your regular projects. So here comes sound sleep and better sleep. And we have to write a regular expression so as to match both of them. Now we can see here, sleep is common in both of them. But coming to sound and better, there is no common thing between these. So what I'll do, here I'll make use of alternation. And inside this parenthesis, I'll write sound with upright bar, then better. Here you can see it's matching both of them. And outside this, I can write sleep. So this regular expression is matching both of the string. Now let's take the other example where we are looking for a document and you are looking for every time that the word principal is spelled incorrectly by writing principal. I hope everyone knows the difference between principal and principal, but we usually make mistakes while writing in a document. But I don't want to highlight these and let the document go without showing any error over here. So how to match these both strings? Let's see. First, I'll write over here in strings. And here we can see up to Princy, it's the same. Even P is matching. But coming to AL and LE, it makes the difference. So I'll do the same thing. I'll write over here Princy. Now here I'll make a parenthesis and we'll write AL upright bar and LE so that it can match both of them. Now if I have pen and pencil, have a thought how we can match this. Till now we have a matter in both these strings, but in this string CIL is missing. So how we can write a regular expression for it? So let's give a try. Here I'll make a group and we'll start writing pen with upright bar and pencil. Oops, here it is not matching because the regular expression engine always reads from left to right. Mind it, regular expression engine always reads from left to right. And as soon as it finds something, it satisfies it, it's eager to return the result to you. That's why we say regular expression engine are eager and greedy. Eager to come first and greedy to have at most everything. This is what this regular expression is doing over here. As soon as it finds P-E-N, as first expression is PN and it is on left, it is in a hurry that we got pen. Okay, let it go. And it just returned only pen. CIL, it is not bothering at all. So how we can resolve it? By writing pencil first, then upright bar and pen. Now this time it is matching both. Why? Because first, it has pencil. Now the rejects knows. Let's take it as a person. He's thinking, first we have given here pencil. So it comes to his mind that there is a pencil over here. Now, when he checks the second expression, he has pencil in his mind. So when it comes to pen, the second word enters to his mind.
So it's completely a matter of left to right. Now let's understand this with one more example where I'll take from A to Z, and while coming to regular expression, I'll write ABC, upright bar, DF, pipeline, GHI, pipeline, and we'll take XYZ from the last, and we will put this in a group. So here, whatever we have given in expression, it is matching to our string. We have four matches over here. So what I'll do, I'll go to flags and will remove this global so that it is matching ABC as our first match. So here you will see that it just matches the first one, and that is because it is eager. It does not look for later matches in the string. It returns the first match which it finds over here. Now instead of ABC, if I write XYZ, and in the last if I write ABC, notice this. It started with the first part of the string, which is ABC, and looked for something that matched there. It did not scan throughout the end. It just looked for ABC if it is matching from regular expression or not. And remember, this is just not a simple line. It might be a 20, 200 page document that we are scanning over here. So it's not going to look throughout the whole document looking for that first choice. It's going to start at the beginning of the document and see if it finds a pattern that matches one of those and will return as it is. This is shown how efficiently regex works. So taking one more example where I have get space get value and set space set value. And with this, if I write regular expression so as to match this, get pipeline get value with this set, and I'll tick on global in my flags. It's just matching get out of get value. Because we have seen regex is eager and greedy, that's why it matched just get out of this. So how to resolve this? First way to resolve this, we can go for get value first, and out of set value and set, we will have set value first and then set. So that you can see it is matching both of them. Now coming to the second way, parenthesis first, and with this we will apply get, and inside this value where the question mark will be there, here it is matching both of them because value we have put in question mark, which means it will be 0 or 1. So in case of get, value is 0, and in case of get value, here it took 1 time. Now similarly, I'll do for set by applying pipeline, and I'll write set and value with question mark. So you can see it's matching both of these string. So you can see it's the most complex because it has that great amount of character range and the greatest repetition. So it's not going to be the most efficient to put first. Rather, small character sets are always going to be more efficient. So this is all about grouping and alternation. In this video, we are going to be looking for anchored expressions. And we will start out by looking at the most common kind of anchors, which are start and end. The meta characters we are going to need here are the caret, dollar sign, backslash A, backslash Z. In this video, we'll be making use of caret and dollar sign, which are used at the start of the string or line, and dollar sign is used at the end of the string or line. caret sign is above 6 on your keyboard. And if you remember, we are using this for the second time. First, it was for neget, and that was specially used with square brackets so as to neget it. Here, it will have the anchor meaning when it's the first character in the regular expression, while dollar sign will have its meaning when it's at the end of the regular session. One important point: for anchor, it refers to the position, not to the actual character. That's why we say it zero width. Other expressions we have been working have a width to them because they refer to characters, and the regular expression engine expects them to match certain number of characters. So here we'll take an example. May. I arrive in the month of May with question mark. Now I want all the capital letters to be matched. How we can match it? Simply by writing square brackets and here A to Z. Here we can match all the capital letters. Now if I want just the first letter, first capital letter to be matched, how we can detect it? Here we'll be making use of caret, which is first M, and this is just used for the first letter of the string. Whereas if I use dollar sign, here it will search for capital letter at the end. But here we don't have any capital letter at the end. So what I'll do, I'll remove this question mark and will write I. So you can see last letter of the string is matched with dollar. Now especially I want to match it with May. So here I can write in the group, it is matching with both May. Now I want the first May to be detected, that is at the start of the string. I can write it with caret and we'll make the string as it is. Let's remove this I, and when I write dollar at last, it will match the last May in our string. Because it sometimes happens in our project when we just specifically needed the last word. So it always be in position, not an actual character. If we want the exact match, what I'll do, I'll just have this May word over here. And if I write caret, it will detect just May as it is the first and the last word in our string. Now let's see for a sentence. When we have my company dot name is NetSet OS. Now the first task to detect the first capital letter, which is M. So for matching the capital letter, I just need to write capital A to Z, that too in square brackets. Now we can see all the capital letters are matched, but I want specifically the first one. So here I can write neget. So you can see the first letter is matched. Now my task is to match the last dot character. So for matching last dot, I can write dot in front of this as it is a literal character, backslash, and with this two dots has been matched, but I want specifically the last one. So I can write dollar sign. So the last dot has been matched. Now I'll write the previous one so as to match my capital letter at the beginning. And next we will write to match the middle letters, which are from capital A to capital Z. It has capitals as well as lowercase also. So A to Z, lowercase, and also we have dot over here. So I can write with space dot and my square bracket will get closed. And as These are more than one character, so I'll apply a plus sign. So you can see the complete string has been matched. Now what if I have been given a mail ID, let's say netsetos@gmail.com. Now so as to match this, we have to divide in three parts. First, netsetos, then @, let's start writing by this, where we have netsetos by \w. Here it is detecting one by one, first n, then et. So here I'll apply plus sign. Then @, then gmail. Gmail is word letter, so \w. Here we got g matched, but we want complete gmail, so I'll write plus. Then a dot. Dot will be treated as literal, so I'll write \.. Then we want com. It can be com, org, mostly three letter word. We are confirmed about it. So we can write here A to Z, because it's always in lowercase as well as just the letters. And they are three in quantity. So I can write three in quantifiers. So we can see complete netsetos@gmail.com has been matched. Now, sometimes we need exactly the mail ID. It is extracting just the mail ID. And by mistakenly what happened here, by human error, somebody wrote space ARR. So here it's an error, because if we have some extractor, so it will be extracting mail with space. So here it is supposed to give error, but our regex is now not ready to give an error, as it is showing just a one match and we don't want it. It is supposed to show an error over here. So what we can do here, we'll be making use of caret and dollar sign, so that it should give error when any space, character or number has been added to any mail ID. Now, if I remove this, it is detecting it. And that's what we want as an exact match. Let's verify. I'll put space over here. And if I write Radhika@yahoo.com, then space Arjun@gmail.com. Here I have added two mails. Completely there are three mail IDs. So here it is supposed to give an error, but I want just the first mail ID. So what I'll do, I'll remove this dollar, and you can see our first mail ID has been matched, and I want the last mail ID. So I'll put $ and we'll delete this caret. And here we got the last mail ID matched. So the conclusion is that caret is supposed to be the first match and $ is last match. So these are the things which are mostly needed and required within our project, and that you will analyze while doing the project. Before ending our video, let's also know there are two types of modes, single line and multi-line. And we will also be knowing how line break is related to multi-line mode. So I'll go to Regexa tool. Here I'll write some of the cosmetics of girls. Cream, shampoo, conditioner, body lotion, lipstick. Now I need to match the first word. So how can I do this? Simply by writing square bracket and inside it A to Z, and here it is detecting just first letter, so I have to write plus sign, and I want just the cream. So what I need to write? Just a caret. Now you can see it is detecting cream over here. Now if I want the last word to be matched, simply I can write by removing this caret dollar sign. But what can I see? It's not matching at all. So why it happened? Because if you see it carefully, there is a next line. That means it's a line break over here. So here it's not matching. Now what I'll do, I'll just remove this enter key. And now it is matching with lipsticks, which is the last word. But if I want to match the enter also, so for this, we can go to flags and we'll click over multi-line. And now it is matching with all line breaks. And that's what we wanted. And this is not specific for this language. It is for every primary language, whether it is Java, Python, Perl. It works for all the languages. So our regex series ends over here. And here I have completed 15 videos for this regex series. As I always tell you, it's a base for any language. So I'll recommend you to go through it and make your basics perfect. So I worked hard for you. I hope you will also support me. So please show your love just by clicking the like button. And please comment and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you.